Hey, Dr. Walter here. I'm gonna show you what a spine looks like, normal alignment, normal spinal model, and why it's important to check it. Why I, as a chiropractor, why chiropractors in general check the spine. So let me show you this spinal model right here. This is a plastic model. So let me back up a bit. All right. So the spine, I'm gonna fix it here, because I use it often in my demonstrations. The spine has a normal alignment of the spine is straight from front to back. So straight from front to back. So normal alignment is straight from front to back. From the side actually has these three curves. So there's curves from the side and then the back side or the front side should be straight. The white blocks over here, these are the bones. There's 24 movable bones in the spine. They're called vertebra. In between, these are the discs. You may have heard of bulging discs, herniated discs, disc degeneration. That can be anywhere along any one of these discs. More commonly, it's in the lower area of the spine, the low back, and also in the neck area, but it can also occur in the middle back. The different regions of the spine, they're called upper part. This is the neck region. That's called the cervical part of the spine, so cervical spine. The middle area where the ribs attach, that's called the thoracic spine. And the low back, that's called the lumbar spine. The low back has 12 vertebra. The middle area, thoracic area has, sorry, back up. The low back has five lumbar vertebra. The middle area has 12 vertebra. And then the cervical area has 7 vertebra. At the bottom, the base of the spine, that's the sacrum. Backside here, sacrum. On the side over here is the pelvis and the pelvis. So the spine sits on the actual sacrum. The sacrum is like a foundation to the rest of the spine. On the inside, this is the whole purpose why chiropractors check it. On the inside, it's gonna be hard for you to see that, but on the inside there, that's where the spinal cord is. So a spinal cord runs from the brain in through the spinal canal behind all of the spinal bones and then ends about L1, L2, and then branches off as nerves that reach into the lower lumbar area, sacral region, and they go into the legs. So every single organ system in your body, every single body part, every single gland, every single cell, every single tissue. In fact, everything in your body connects to your brain through the spinal cord, which is inside the spinal column, through all these nerves called spinal nerves. There's 31 pairs of nerves, 31 on each side. So if you look at this poster down here, see if I can tilt this a bit. It's gonna be hard for you to see there, but this is the brain. Spinal column, inside the spinal column is the spinal cord. Spinal cord branches out to 31 nerves that goes to all your organ systems. So there is nothing in your systems, in your body, that does not connect to the brain through your spine. And that is why, as chiropractors, we check the spine. It is impossible to have an optimal health or express full health and be well without the brain connecting properly with your body. And you don't have to take my word for that. I mean, look at some of these extreme case examples. Someone like Christopher Reeves, if you remember him, he played Superman in the 80s, 70s and 80s. Great movies and a great actor. He had an injury. He fell off the horse, horseback riding, fell off a horse, and he fractured a part of his neck at the very top. That bony fracture, that bony fragment injured his spinal cord. What happened? He actually was paralyzed from the neck down. Couldn't move his arms, couldn't move his legs. Couldn't function and needed all kinds of support, was in a wheelchair. So he had no connection from his brain to the rest of his body into the parts of his body that controlled his major organ systems and also his arms and legs, especially his arms and legs. So he couldn't walk, couldn't move. So he had no connection from brain to body from the neck down. So he couldn't function very well. So that's how important it is for that. If you heard of other spinal cord injury cases, you'll see that when there's a spinal cord injury, people do not function to the full capacity. They're very, very limited, very disabled. So the same thing happens without extreme cases in the same idea. So when the spine should have a normal curve, right? And if someone begins to bend forward like that with their spine and their posture, now what they're doing is they're stressing the bones over here where the bending is occurring, causes advanced degeneration to occur. But more importantly, it's actually stretching the spinal cord on the inside, irritating that nervous system. And it can cause a whole bunch of local inflammation, which leads to pain response, muscle tightness, immobility, increases the stress response in the body, alters posture, which is not good, and over time can actually degenerate. But more importantly, it's actually irritating the nervous system and basically interfering with that connection from brain to body. So that cannot lead to good things. So as a chiropractor, we check for these misalignments. If they're twisted or turned, we check for these abnormal positions of the spine, and then we apply corrective techniques to actually correct it. So put them into proper position and restore that normal alignment. The amazing part is that people get well when we do that. It's phenomenal. So when there is that interference from connection of brain to body, people are sick. When there is a better connection from brain to body, people are well. And as chiropractors, we help facilitate that correction. But the healing happens within you naturally, because that healing ability is already inherent and innate in you. And it travels through the connections of the nervous system. But when it's interfered with, that connection interferes with that healing ability. When we restore alignment, that connection is restored. And now people function, heal, and their body's repairing better. And they're having less stress, less inflammation, improved posture. And they're living their life really, really well. So it's kind of a crash course on spinal anatomy, why we check it as a chiropractor, the relevance to the nervous system, and overall people's health status. If you have any questions while you're watching, just pop them in the comments below. I'll stay on for another few seconds to see if there's any questions. If you like this tutorial, be sure to give me some thumbs up, hit the like button, share it with your family and friends. You know, I find that spinal health seems to be the big missing link to people's health improvement these days. Many people have been taught that you need to eat well, and that's true. You got to eat well, have good foods, put good food into your body. You need to drink good fluids, water, really, really good water. You need to exercise, keep your body moving. All these are important. Stress is a big factor these days. You need to watch your stress levels and manage and have strategies for stress. You need to have good sleep, rest, and recovery. But I want to ask you, have you ever been told that you need to keep your spine aligned properly and taken care of? Because you know what? It protects the nervous system, and that controls everything else anyways. You can do all the other things really well and habitually, which is great. But if this is like that, then now you're going to be limited big time with your health. And that's where chiropractic comes in. Chiropractic is the missing key to people's healthcare in most cases. But more and more people are realizing it that these days. And when they're not finding the solution elsewhere with other things that they're doing, they come to chiropractic office, and it tends to be that last resort that really, really helped them. So that's my tutorial video for today. Hope you enjoyed it. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you on the next video.